In this work, we present a novel approach to perform tree reconstruction for forest inventory. Our pipeline runs in real time on a mobile mapping system, which consists of a LiDAR, an IMU, three cameras, and a small compute unit. With its compact form factor, the mapping system can easily be carried on a backpack or mounted on a mobile robot such as the animal. Walking the robot through the forest, we estimate its pose using LiDAR inertial odometry and correct for drift using a SLAM system. We collect blocks of LiDAR data every 20 meters traveled, which we call payload point clouds. To perform the reconstruction, we propose a real-time pipeline to process the stream of payloads and detect trees in a consistent manner. This pipeline takes the payload clouds as an input, as well as the SLAM pose graph, which it uses to constantly realign the measurements. As a first step of reconstruction, we model the terrain using a cloth simulation filter. We then remove ground points by proximity to this terrain. For clustering, we now need robust estimates of the stem axes. To find these, we use non-maximum suppression on several axis candidates at different heights. For this, we crop the point cloud at several height intervals and cluster it using the dbScan algorithm. Then, we fit cylinders to the clusters and judge the fitting quality using a scoring function. Finally, we select the best ones for every tree using non-maximum suppression. With these cylinders as preliminary tree axes, we cluster the full point cloud following the Voronoi paradigm. Over the course of several payloads, we merge clusters at the same location into tree instances. We measure the coverage angle for every tree instance, and only once it indicates that enough data has been accumulated, we initiate reconstruction. For this, we slice the point clouds at regular height intervals. Every color corresponds to a cluster originating from a different payload cloud. We now want to find the circular cross-section, but especially in this difficult example, this is impaired by noise originating from twigs and branches. So we first filter these outliers by applying the Hough transform to each sliced cluster. The classical Hough transform uses a rasterized input point cloud and Hough space to accumulate votes. Then, the best circle fit is found at the voxel in the Hough space with the most votes. However, we found this method not to be robust in the presence of the noise we are dealing with. So we employ a continuous form of this algorithm, the randomized Hough transform. In the continuous Hough space, each point votes along a cone with unit slope. Wherever many cones intersect, which means that many votes are cast, we expect the best circle fit. As it is not easy to find these intersections analytically, we use the intersection points of many cone triplets as a proxy. These cone triplets intersect at the Hough representation of the circle going through the three sampled points. As the number of triplets grows cubically, we only sample a subset of triplets, which follows the Ransack paradigm. Finally, the point with the most neighbors within a given radius approximates the most voted circle in the Hough space. We use the corresponding circle in Cartesian space to filter all outliers in the sliced point clouds. To the remaining points, we fit a circle in the least squares sense. After applying this procedure to all payload clusters of the slice, we average the models yielding the final circle fit. Using stacked oblique cone frustums between these circles, we build the final model of the tree. We demonstrate this pipeline by deploying a quadruped robot carrying our mobile mapping system on a fully autonomous mission. Note that using the SLAM system, the data is kept globally consistent at all times. Relevant tree trace can now be extracted from the reconstructed models, which can be compiled into an industry-standard telescope.